So Softmax, the Softmax activation function, is just like a generalized version of the logistic sigmoid function. It's a very similar concept, except now that it combines the activations from the multiple sets of weights. So for a second, assume that we don't use the Softmax activation function, and we are just using the regular sigmoid activation function. So for each weight here, or for each set of weights, we have the sigmoid activation function. As a consequence, the values returned by the sigmoid activation by each one will be a value between 0 and 1. So what you might notice is that we have a probability of 0.8, 0.7 and 0.9, and those, they don't sum up to 1. So for example, if we have a classification problem where we classify bird, cat and dog, we might have an 80% chance of predictor probability that an image belongs to a dog, 70% that it might be a cat, and 90% that it might be a bird. And for a statistician, this might not make any sense or might be quite unintuitive. That's because we have like these probability scores that don't sum up to 1. And if we think about classes like that, cat, bird and dog, we want them to sum up to 1 if they are mutually exclusive classes. So to address this issue, to make these probability scores sum up to 1, we use the softmax activation function, which is essentially a modified version of the sigmoid activation function that rescales the probabilities so that they sum up to 1. So we might say that the softmax converts its input values into a probability distribution. So how does this actually work? Let's take a quick look at the softmax activation function. So we are now focusing in on the part that converts the net inputs into these probability scores that sum up to 1. So here's the mathematical formula for the softmax regression function, and we are now going to discuss it step by step. So first of all, we should clarify that we are looking at a single training example here. So I stands for the ith training example, and Z is the net input. So we are taking a look at the net input of the ith training example here. And similar to the logistic activation function, the softmax activation function is a score that represents a class membership probability. So here it's the probability that a given input belongs to class T, given its features. So here this probability membership score might refer to one of these sets of weights followed by the softmax activation function. So if we look at the first class label, if class label T equals 0, then we might be looking at the first part of the graph here. And softmax regression works for an arbitrary number of labels. So T here can be any number between 0 and let's say 99 if we have 100 classes, or even larger than that. So here we are denoting the values J to H as the minimum or the first class label. And then the number H corresponds to the largest class label. So now we have this fraction here, where in the numerator we have e to the power of the net inputs. So in a sense, this will be very similar to what we had with the logistic activation function. However, what's different here is that we have this denominator term, which combines all the different activation functions. So we have e to the power of the activation function across all the different classes. And yeah, this is essentially a normalization term. So we sum over all these e to the power of the net input terms for each of the different classes to normalize the scores such that they sum up to 1. Because looking at the mathematical formula can be a bit intimidating, let's actually walk through some code snippets to illustrate this further. So assume we have the following net inputs here. So Z is a matrix consisting of 2 rows and 3 columns. Each row corresponds to a training example, and each of the columns corresponds to a class label. So in this case, we would have a training dataset consisting of 2 training examples and class labels 0, 1, and 2. Now let's pick out the first class label, let's say class label 0, which will be corresponding to the first set of weights here in the figure below. And we have 2 rows because we have 2 training examples. So if we then apply the softmax activation function, we convert these net inputs, or the 2 training examples, into class membership probabilities. So this number, 6.3e minus 0.2, might look a bit weird at first. So this is just a compact scientific notation, but it essentially means a 6.3 times 10 to the power of minus 2, which is still a bit intimidating, of course, but it's just a way of how some people prefer to write scientific notation. So the value we are just looking at here is really just 0.063. And what we want is that all the values in each row sum up to 1. And since the scientific notation can be sometimes a bit tricky to look at, here's a way we can actually change that to show us the decimal point representation. And based on this decimal point representation, I hope you can see that all the values now in each row sum up to 1. So in this video, we went over the computation of the softmax activation function, and in the next part, we will cover how we take these class membership probabilities and convert them into class labels.